Then there is Satan and Yetzirah. Moshe Rabbeinu had to hide 80 years to be able to protect himself and to be able afterwards to come back to Mitzrayim to save Am Yisrael. David HaMelech, the same story and even worse. David HaMelech, the people thought that he was a mamzer. Right? The only one that was a gingy. How you say gingy in English? Red hair. Right? The only one. And everybody was, the Midrash write, that every single problem that he was in the city, they were blaming the King David. There was someone that stole. Who was it? Oh, it was for sure David. Someone broke something. Oh, what? David. David HaMelech had a very tough life. Why? Just to show to the same sitra, hara, from here for sure, no goel can come out. Always when there is kedusha, rabotai, the yetzerara is on a fight against it. If there is no kedusha, there is no yetzerara. So instead of complaining and saying, oh, why is it so hard for me? You know, I'm trying to do teshuvah, I'm trying to learn a little bit more, but always the yetzerara is attacking, is dafka because you have a great potential. Dafka because of that. Because if there was no kedusha, there was no yetzerara trying to fight against it. That's number one. But number two, Rabotai, we ask, oh, and by the way, that's the reason why there is no Shemot. Everything is hided. But it's Peneu Sheloshai Erachim, right? The Chevetz is hiding Moshe Rabbeinu 3 months. Everything hiding. Not to say, not to talk too much. Why? Ena Berecha Shruya, Ela Bedavar Asamui Min Ha'ayin. You want to have Berecha in your house, in your family? Shh, keep it quiet. Don't show it off. Don't be, you know, more quiet you do it, more beracha and more success you're going to have. But Rabotai, I heard the fantastic perush. There is mahloket in between the Midrash and Pirkei Rabbi Natan. We know that there were Shiv'aim Nefesh Yardu Avotenu B'Mitzrayim. 70 people came down to Egypt from Yaakov Avinu. When they came down to Egypt, there were 70. The Torah is telling us all the names. When you count the names, you find exactly 69. We're missing one. We're missing one. Who is this 70? So there is machloket. One opinion says, was Yocheved. Why Yocheved? Yocheved was born ben Achomot. The mother of Yocheved was pregnant. When they were going down to Egypt, and she was born mamash when they got to the right to the border of Mitzrayim, ben Achomot. That's one opinion. Second opinion is that the 70 is the Shekhinah. It's not a person. It's the presence of God. Why? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu promised to Yaakov, Anochi eredimach, v'gam Anochi elcha gam alo. I'm going to be going down with you to Mitzrayim, and I will go up. I will take you out from Mitzrayim. Yeah, I'm going to be with you, taking you out. Therefore, according to this Perush, I'm telling you to machloket. According to this Perush, the number 70 was the Shekhinah. Rabotai, when you open up the Zohar HaKadosh, gives a great light. Zohar HaKadosh in Parashat Shemot. He writes that when Am Yisrael went down to Egypt, there was 69, 70 with the Shekhinah. But then he writes, and from the words you can be medayek this, that the Shekhinah, where was this Shekhinah? Inside Yocheved. Who was carrying the Shekhinah? Yocheved. Meaning there is no machloket. Both of the opinions are real. Just is one complementing the other one. Yocheved that was born at this limit, she was the recipient to get the Shekhinah on it. You know who knew about it? Amram. And Amram was marrying Yocheved Leshem Shamayim. What was the Shem Shamayim? He knew that Yocheved had this power, the Shekhinah is on her. By the way, Yocheved, she lived all of the years, 210 years in Mitzrayim of Shiabud. And she was able also to live the 40 years in the Midbar, and she got inside Eretz Yisrael. Yocheved. Why? Because she carried the Shekhinah. Yes. And that's why Abraham, when he knew that there is such a potential, he knew that if from him will come the leader and the Mashiach of that generation, okay, he took Yocheved, being his aunt, much older than him. Why you have to look for a lady that is much older than him? Leshem Shamayim. An amazing chidush over here about Moshe Rabbeinu. Huh? Abraham said the Gemara, there is one of the four people that he died by Aityosh and Nahash, writes the Gemara. What's Aityosh and Nahash? Aityosh and Nahash is that he didn't make any sin in his life. Any sin he did. But he died because of the decree that the snake, you know, by the sin of Adam Arishon, right? He died because of that. The Gemara writes there are four. Who are the four? Says the Gemara, Abraham, okay? Abraham, Avi Moshe. Then you have, let me remember good. Then you have Ishai, Avi David. Then you have one of the sons of David HaMelech, right? And then you have the fourth one. I'm missing one. One of the sons of David HaMelech. He died also, but because he had no sins. Okay? No. I forget the name. Okay. Bezat Hashem, I will owe you that one. Okay, Rabotai? So very interesting, just to get this point, that always when you gotta get beracha in your life, Rabotai, is only when you're doing the things quietly. That's how it works. You wanna get siyata dishmaya in the business, in the family, don't try to, you know, show it off too much. Keep it quiet and you're gonna see a lot of beracha. I wanna just tell you a great, great story that I heard, and with this I'm done. Story goes that there was a couple that unfortunately didn't have children. And every time that she was getting pregnant, lo aleinu, she was miscarriaging. Every time. I don't know, she was getting pregnant, something wrong was going. So they decided to go to one of the rabbis. And the rabbi said, tell me something. When you're getting pregnant, what is the first thing you do? So the first thing I do, I call up my family. Oh, you call up your family? Yes. What is your family? He said, my parents of my husband, my brothers, my siblings, and also the close friends, you know, close people. The rabbi told him, listen, from now on, I want you, at the moment that you get pregnant, you will not say even to your parents. Until the third month. But Rabbi, they're going to get upset. Listen, you want to have the baby, right? Don't talk to it. And only after the 3 months, you will tell to your parents, and that's it. And only whoever will realize, B'ezrat Hashem, you know, throughout the month, you will say, yeah, and that's it. Rabotai, we don't even realize. This couple, Baruch Hashem, they got pregnant again, and they follow whatever the rabbi said. At the beginning, the parents got a little bit, how you didn't tell us, only it's already the third month. Says that's what the rabbi said. And Baruch Hashem, they had the baby. He said, we didn't even understood what the Gemara wrote. The Gemara writes that 90-something percent of the people in the world, they died because of the Ayin Hara, 99% of the people. Because of the Ayin Hara. Ayin Hara is not a sickness. Ayin Hara can be many things. There are people that are getting hurt. There are people that are getting sick. There are people that are getting all type of tragedies. And everything is connected to the Ayin Hara. How much careful you gotta have? Baruch Hashem, today, whatever you can keep quiet. Whatever you can keep quiet. Your wife, Baruch Hashem, is pregnant. You don't have to say it at the first months. Keep it quiet. Baruch Hashem, everybody now sees it because she's in the seventh. You don't have to make parties. Fortunately, there is a type of mentality to make parties. Why? Because right now she's pregnant. Wait, the baby was born yet? She wasn't born. Once he will be born, you do kiddush. That yes. Lechaim if it is a girl, and if it is a boy, do brit milah. And that's it. Why lechaim for the girls? Very interesting. I had a family member that she got at the age of 18, 19. She was looking to get married. No shidduch. She was trying. No shidduch. She did many shidduchim. The years are passing. She's not finding shidduch. One day she went to one of the gdonim to get a beracha. And the gadol looked at her and he told her, tell me something. Did your parents did kiddush when you were born? I said, kiddush? Well, I don't know. I mean, I don't remember. Let me ask them. She went in and she asked. I said, no. Why no? We didn't have enough money back then. We didn't do any kiddush. The rabbi told them, right now do a kiddush of your birth. Now, 18, 19. Why? He says, do it. They did it. Baruch Hashem, that same year, she got engaged. When she asked the rabbi, what's the idea behind it? He said, because it's right that a person has to hide himself, but at the same time, you have to appreciate it to say thank you to Borei Olam. What's the best way to say thank you? Berov am hadrat menech. More when you do a party and you're inviting people and you're showing to Borei Olam the chesed that God gave to you, then Borei Olam is he can continue giving the beracha in each one of us. Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen ve'amen.